with me, Lena AS Editions, and this is the second assignment of Team Be Unique, which is the team of Forever Editor, which is Bailey. Her link will be down in the description below, along with all my teammates. So the assignment was actually pretty interesting, and it was some tips on how to be a better YouTuber. So I just put like some stuff that came to my mind, and I got some ideas from some videos I watched. So credits go to the people down in the description below once I find their videos. And yeah, I mean, they're just random tips on how to be a better YouTuber. So let's just get into it. Okay, so tips to be a better YouTuber. So I'm not that big and I'm not that successful. So these tips are just like some general tips. I'm not trying to show off or something. So I hope you know that. So first of all, speak clearly. Now, some people sometimes talk with like low voice or like sometimes like the microphone that you have is not so good, so your voice isn't really heard. And I'm pretty sure everybody like has this problem at some point. Like, I don't know if I have that, and if I do, then I'm sorry. I mean, I try my best to actually pronounce the words correctly and slowly. So I hope that really helps. And if it doesn't, then just comment, and I'll try to work on it, I guess. So the second thing is interact with your subscribers, which means have contests, maybe like giveaways, have like a talk video, or like the, you know, like answering questions, or maybe even like a live chat or something. I've never tried that, but I think some YouTubers have. I mean, you could always try that. Like, it would be fun, I guess, like just talking to people. And you can interact with them on Facebook if you have a fan account, or you can make one. You can interact on Twitter, ask a fan, you know, like any social media, or even like on YouTube, like messages and stuff. So I mean, interacting with them is really good. It's nice to have like YouTube friends, so just stay like interacted with your subscribers and stay close to them. So third thing is have a good quality video. It doesn't really matter how good the quality is, but like if your quality is like 144 or like 240 and like the whole screen is scratchy and stuff and you can't hear the voice because it's too low quality, that is not good, guys. You won't get like too many views or likes or something. So just like try your best to get it at least to like 360. I mean, most of my videos have an HD option, like 720. Some of them I think have like 1080, which is awesome, but it takes a long time to load. So I mean, just try your best to do that. But I mean, it's okay if you don't have it, but I suggest you do. Fourth thing, don't use notes that often. And I don't mean notes like this, like where you can keep like your background notes. I mean making like note tutorials or videos, you know, not using your voice. I know that a lot of starters, like people who start their channels, they usually use notes first, and I did that too. I've done that like for a few months, actually like 4 or 5 months, because it's kind of easier for us. And so like since I was a beginner, it was easier for me. I didn't even know like I could speak and stuff, and I'm kind of like, I don't like my voice, not on record, no. And so I speed it up now, but I didn't really know how to speed it up before, so I just used the note. I still do now, but I don't make each video with a note, like once a month or twice a month, like when you are really bored and you don't want to talk, then you can just use the note, you know, but don't use it like in every video. It just gets boring in the end, and you lose your subscribers, basically. Then, don't be rude, neither in the comments or in a video, or like dislike someone's video because they copied you or something, which they didn't. And just don't be rude, because they wouldn't be happy with you, and they could like go report your channel or like spam you or something, which is not so fun. Just keep a good relationship with all YouTubers around you. Then we have the most important rule, which is don't be a show-off, you know? No matter how big you get, I don't care if you have like a million subscribers, don't be a show-off and be like, oh, you have just 100, who cares about you? No, just be modest, be happy, be grateful for all the subscribers you have. I mean, I know I do that. You know what? I would have never got here, you know? Okay, I don't know what I'm talking about, but like, thank you so much. I mean, it's all because of you, so. And I really hope you don't see me as a show-off. If you do, then just confront me. I'd like to change that. So, keep your stuff organized, like I'm doing now. Like, if you need a note, to, like, have some background notes or something, then do it. Nobody's gonna kill you or something. And it's pretty, you know, it's really helpful. Like, some people actually make videos, like, without notes, and sometimes hard to remember something. For example, you're like, oh, what I was gonna say is, and you forget. So it's easier to have a note, and it's good to have your desktop organized. Like, I don't have anything. I have my widgets and the thing I'm using now. And as you can see, everything is pretty organized here. My videos, my documents, not gonna show you my pictures, but my downloads are pretty messy, so don't really look at those. I'm pretty sure I'm gonna make them more organized in the future, in the far, far away future. This one's kind of similar to the one before, and it's have an idea of what you're going to say. For example, like if you're in a tutorial and you don't know the steps really well, for example, this is kind of what I do. Like I make the lend once, and then the second time or like the third time, I make the tutorial. So sometimes I'm not too handy with it, so I usually keep stopping and going back and seeing what I did and checking the PSD and stuff, which is good. But don't be like, oh, what did I do after that? Did I add this one or this layer or that text? Just keep your stuff organized and know what you're gonna do and what you're gonna say. And if you get somehow confused, then just stop the video immediately, get your thoughts together, and continue. Simple as that. Then we have pause frequently to get your ideas straight. I sometimes forget to pause, but like in videos like this, I usually pause to check what the next point is, to have my ideas, to know what I'm gonna talk about, like what I'm gonna mention, which is really good at before, because like if I just like scroll down and I find like respond to comments, I would be like, oh, what do I have to say? So it's good to pause frequently, like to think it out and then talk. So then we have respond to comments, which is a pretty important point, I guess, because like many YouTubers like have all these comments on their videos and they don't respond. I mean, like when I get a video, I usually respond, especially if it was a question, like if it was a compliment, I usually, if it was like one compliment, I'd say thank you, but like if like 10 people comment, it would be hard to like keep saying thank you, it would be just cheesy then. So I just, you know, I usually like respond to questions, and if I don't, then I'm sorry, it's probably I didn't notice your message or your comment, or I forgot about it. And if you have like a really, really urgent like comment or question, then just message me, because I respond to messages much more than I respond to my comments. So then we have don't curse, which is a pretty important point actually. I don't think I've ever heard someone curse in a video, and I hope I haven't done that. I don't know if I do, and if I did, then it's probably like spontaneous, so I'm sorry if I did. And it's just not nice, like you're talking and then boom, a word out of nowhere. It's just not nice. And like if the person, like some YouTubers or editors or something are kind of young, like 10 years old or 9, it's not really good to talk like that, and it's not good for your reputation. Like they'd be, oh yeah, Lena has additions, yeah, the YouTuber who curses a lot. That's not a good reputation, guys, so just try your best not to curse. Don't rush your videos. Try your best not to rush them. I sometimes do that when it gets too long, like I'm doing now, because the video, I think, exceeded like 10 minutes, so like try not to rush it, especially like in blends, like give instructions. Don't like we just merge that, add that, color that, give them like colorize it, Ctrl plus U. Just give instructions and just don't rush the thing, or else people won't be like, they won't understand. They would be like, could you redo it and stuff? So just take your time. And now the most important thing is be you, because there's no one better. So don't try like to imitate someone or copy someone. Just be yourself. Act normal. Don't be like a robot, like, hello, this is a tutorial by. Just be natural. I mean, I try my best to be natural, and if I get like bloopers and stuff, I never delete them out. That's why when I edit my video, I just add an intro and stuff and music and whatever I do. So I usually don't get bloopers out, and if I do, I just put them in the when the video ends, because it's just fun, and it's like fun to be natural with your subscribers, let them know who you really are, not just like a robot. So, and the last thing, which I don't need to pause for, just have fun. You know, you've made this your channel like to have fun, to like interact with people, to make tutorials. Don't do it for money, don't do it like for just like for subscribers, just do it to have fun. So I mean, just try your best to have fun. If you feel like pressure, then just take a rest for a few days, a few weeks, you know, just come back when you actually feel like you're having fun. So I mean, that's basically it for this point. So that's actually all for this video, and I'm sorry that it's getting too long, I really am, but I really hope that those tips were kind of helpful. And if they were, then make sure to thumbs up this video and comment what you think of my tips, and make sure you subscribe to me for more videos. And yeah, just, you know, stay tuned to my next video later, I guess. And yeah, bye!